You have not entered into any competition here. Just to relax. Just relax. Then the more you want to do about Sahaja Yoga, again you are tense. I have to meditate early in the morning, I have to get up tomorrow early in the morning. You see, you go on questioning yourself, whole night you won't sleep. And when you are meditating, you are dozing. Relax. God is looking after you, believe. He is going to give you realization and He is going to look after you and He is going to wake you up in the morning too. But relax. The first idea that I can do it is wrong. He has to. It's not working out because you think you can do it. If you can come to this conclusion that I cannot do it, it is His mercy, His graciousness has to come. But after realization, you have to do something in the sense, you have to desire. But when I say you have to desire it again, you will say, all right, now I'm going to sit down here and nail myself to this place and I'm going to sit down and desire it. This desire is a dead desire, you see, just pushed onto your head that, oh, I must desire, Mother has told I must desire. You have to be hungry. You don't say that I have to desire that I have to be hungry, do you? The hunger is from within, which is there, no doubt. But is clouded. The hunger is clouded because you have fear. If you put a goat before a tiger and give him to eat, he will reduce with that eating whatever it is. Because it has that fear that there is a tiger which is going to eat him. So first kill all the imaginary tigers around you. Again we come back to the same. That desire must come from within. And it is there. What is clouded? Relax. It should not be that I am very relaxed. It's chalna. It's simple. A relaxed person is just like a child. So not to get frightened, try to relax. That's all. For everyone. But relaxation never means that you are inactive. On the contrary, the person who is relaxed is extremely active. On the exterior, but inside is absolutely silent, absolutely relaxed and at ease. Outside you may feel, as you know now, at this time tremendous vibrations are flowing. And I can see the flow, tremendous. And all the chakras are doing like this around me. But I see them and they are playing. At the most I may stop talking. But it is flowing. So whether it is for the seeking or for anything else in the world, the first thing is that you must take an attitude of a relaxed witness. If you can do that, then those who are not feeling vibrations will definitely feel. I've seen people on whom I've been working, it wouldn't work out. Of course, they were not rude or anything arrogant, but felt very sad that they couldn't get the vibration. So I said, all right, today you go and enjoy the flowers in the garden, enjoy the birds, and talk to the sky and come back to me. It works out. Because you have been always like this. In Sahaja Yoga, you don't have to achieve anything. You become. First you become, and then mentally you understand Sahaja Yoga. But those who try to understand Sahaja Yoga mentally first are really in for trouble. Because when you read it, it sounds so great and you think, oh God, where am I? So, please, if you give realization to someone, take it easy. It will grow. Don't give advent to it next moment. We do it. Why? We think we should impress the person that Sahaja Yoga is a great thing and the person must read advent, so he'll come to Sahaja Yoga and we'll establish this man because he will see and will be impressed. If somebody is going to be impressed by these things, such a person is of no use for Sahaja Yoga. Take it from me. If they are going to be impressed by something exterior and superficial, how far will they go? They have to achieve it within themselves, their own spirit. They have to be impressed by themselves, by their own achievement.